At Apple with the new iPhones. The iPhone 6 has split into two different types, the iPhone 6 and the iPhone 6 Plus. They're both going to be available September 19th at two different prices, starting at $199 for the 6 and $299 for the 6 Plus. So what's the difference? They both have larger screens. The 6 is a 4.7-inch screen compared to the 4-inch on the iPhone 5. 1334 by 750, it's about 38% more pixels. And this has a 1920 by 1080p display, 5.5-inch screen. Now, this is the territory of a phablet or a phone tablet, but it feels pretty good in the hand, and Apple has actually come out with a quick double tap to access your apps with one hand in case you feel a little too intimidating. They both have revamped cameras. One has optical image stabilization. That's the 6 Plus. That keeps your phone shots more stable, and it uses technology that's normally in cameras, but it is making its way into more and more smartphones. These both run iOS 8, of course, and the design has been revamped to be curved more like the iPod Touch or even the iPad, very sleek and still space gray, gold, and silver. You can get a little more storage for your money, too. 16 gigabytes for $199 in the 6 or $299 here. But then the next bump up is 64 gigabytes, and the top end is $128. So that's pretty nice. And did I mention these are the only two phones that will work with Apple Pay, Apple's new payment system that's going to be deploying, working like a mobile wallet to enable you to pay at various stores that have contactless wireless systems. Now, what about battery life? These both have a little bit of battery life game, anywhere from 1 to 2 hours or a little bit more, depending on what use, according to Apple, for video or web browsing. You're going to get a little more battery life juice out of the iPhone 6 Plus, but stay tuned for our testing at CNET. Which one do I like? I mean, I still like a more discreet phone, but I gotta say, for 5.5-inch, this does feel pretty portable compared to others I've seen. I'm Scott, taking a look at the new iPhones here in Cupertino.